Hello children, welcome back. This is again Mrs. Reema Udani, and I'm sure all of you are safe and healthy. I'm sure that you must have already seen the part one of this video. We continue part two of the same chapter, The Earth in the Solar System. So buckle up, fasten your seatbelts, and let's take the remaining tour of a solar system. So, in the part 2 of this chapter, we are going to start off by learning about the solar system. The sun, 8 planets, satellites, and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteoroids form the solar system. We will learn about asteroids and meteoroids in this video. We often call this the solar family, with the sun as its head. Did you know that Sol in Roman mythology is the sun god? Solar means related to the sun. The family of the sun is therefore called the solar system. Now let's learn about the sun. The sun is the center of the solar system. It is huge and made up of extremely hot gases. It provides the pulling force that holds the solar system. The sun is the ultimate source of heat for the entire solar system. But that tremendous heat is not felt so much by us because, despite being our nearest star, it is still far away from us. The sun is about 150 million kilometers away from the Earth. Did you know that light travels at the speed of about 3 lakh kilometers per second? Yet, even with this speed, the light of the sun takes about 8 minutes to reach the Earth. Let's learn about our very own planet, the Earth. The Earth is the third nearest planet to the sun. It is the fifth largest planet. It is slightly flattened at the poles. That is why its shape is described as a geoid. Geoid means an earth-like shape. Conditions on the Earth are favorable to support life. That is why life is probably found only on the Earth. The Earth is neither too hot nor too cold. It has water and air, which are very essential for our survival. The air has life-supporting gases like oxygen. Because of these reasons, the Earth is a unique planet in the solar system. From the outer space, the Earth appears blue because 2/3 surface is covered by water. It is therefore called a blue planet. The Moon. Our Earth has only one satellite, that is the Moon. Its diameter is only 1/4 that of the Earth. It appears so big because it is nearer to our planet than the other celestial bodies. It is about 384,400 kilometers away from us. The Moon moves around the Earth in about 27 days. It takes exactly the same time to complete one spin. That's why we can see one side of the Moon only. The Moon does not have favorable conditions for life. It does not have water or air. It has mountains, plains, and depressions called craters on its surface. These cast shadows on the Moon's surface. Did you know that Neil Armstrong was the first man to step on the surface of the Moon on the 29th of July 1969? Rakesh Sharma was the first Indian to land on the Moon on the 3rd of April 1984. Now let's come to satellites. We know from the previous slides that the Moon is a satellite. What is a satellite? A satellite is a celestial body that moves around the planets. For us, the moon is our satellite and it orbits around the Earth. Now, there are two kinds of satellites. One is a natural satellite, which is the moon, and the other is a human-made satellite. The human-made satellite is an artificial body. It moves around the Earth, but its objective is to gather data about the universe or to communicate. Some of the Indian satellites in space are the INSAT, the IRS, the EDUSAT. Now let's learn about asteroids. Apart from the stars, planets, and satellites, there are numerous tiny bodies which also move around the sun. These bodies are called asteroids. The picture on your screen will show you that there is an asteroid belt between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Scientists are of the view that asteroids are parts of a planet which exploded many years back. Just like asteroids, there are meteoroids. These are small pieces of rocks which move around the sun. They're also called shooting stars. Sometimes these meteoroids come near the Earth and tend to drop upon it. During this process, due to the friction with the air, they get heated up and burn. It causes a flash of light. On the picture, you see that every meteoroid has a small little tail. Sometimes a meteor, without being completely burnt, called a meteorite, falls on the Earth and creates a hollow. Let's look at a larger picture, the galaxy. A cluster of a million of stars. This band is called the Milky Way galaxy. Our solar system is a part of this galaxy. In ancient India, it was imagined to be a river of light flowing into the sky. Hence, it was named Akash Ganga. A galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and clouds of dust and gases. There are millions of such galaxies that make the universe. Do you see a whitish broad band like a white glowing path across the sky on a clear starry night? It is difficult to imagine how big the universe is. Scientists are still trying to find out more and more about it. We are not certain about its size, but we surely know that all of us, you and I, belong to this universe. Here is a revision web that will help you remember and learn everything at a glance. I'm sure it'll prove helpful to you. That's the end of the video. Thank you for watching. Below is the link to all NCERT downloadable books. Stay home and stay safe till we meet again. Bye.